let's have a complete overview of what are the features that we have in latest SAP SAP ABAP version. So the SAP ABAP version that we are talking about is ABAP 7.4. So after the ABAP 7.4 version, so what are the features that we have is what we are going to discuss in this particular session. Okay, so let's start with this SAP ABAP, the 7.4 latest features. In this, we're going to discuss about the overview of performance tooling, overview of ABAP optimizations for SAP HANA, integration of SAP HANA features into ABAP Code Outlook. So we have, so SAP NetWeaver. So we have SAP NetWeaver application server ABAP 7.4 powered by SAP HANA. We have to get the data from two different sources, guys. So we are focusing on the SAP NetWeaver application server ABAP 7.4. Okay. In this, we'll have the HANA database and we'll have the classic database. So HANA database is something which we are going to connect and work upon. And we are also going to connect to the classical database. Now then we have on the top of it, we have the SAP business suite. The suit on SAP HANA, and then we have the business bureaus. So we have, SAP business suite is something which we have logged in into the S4 HANA, right? So we have logged into S4 HANA through the HANA studio. So we also created the packages and programs and those things. So those all we were doing on this particular suite. So we are logged in into the suite and then doing it. And business bureaus again will have another login from where we can do the business bureaus processing. So we have, we will be going to the release of SAP NetWeaver and for ABAP development for SAP HANA. So next enhancement packages after SAP NetWeaver 7.03 and 7.1. So it's been very long time. It's like, this SAP NetWeaver concept was initially released in the May of 2013, but actually it was stabilized and people got to know about NetWeaver technology in 2014. And supports SAP HANA and other classic databases. So that release of NetWeaver is what will support our SAP HANA platform. So now what exactly is NetWeaver? NetWeaver is a combination of multiple technologies, guys. So I'm going to discuss about NetWeaver in short later point of time. But we have a NetWeaver application and continuous innovations without disruptions, extension to mobile, big data and cloud, seamless end-to-end development experience based on Eclipse. So you can do everything from the Eclipse, right? So you can do everything from the Eclipse. You can do the development from the Eclipse. So continuous innovation without disruption. And we have enabler for real-time business. Now, let's say I have said you, initially I've discussed with you that business bureaus used to have a different database and S4 HANA suite used to have, the ECC server, which used to be the OLTP system used to be having a different database and OLAP system used to have a different database. But now both are on the same database, so we can do the real-time analysis of data. Previously, real-time analysis of data was not possible. And business bureaus after 7.4, it was launched on HANA platform. Before 7.4 version of business bureaus, it was on any database. Okay, it was database independent. Later from 7.4, they have made it as database dependent, means it will be working only on HANA database. And we have a custom applications from where we can access the data. Now, SAP NetWeaver application server ABAP 7.4 powered by SAP HANA highlights at a glance. So we have, these are the highlights. We have development tools in Eclipse, performance tooling and gateway. So as we discussed all the different tools from which we are going to get the data, we have different tools from which we do the performance analysis of ABAP programming. These are all imbibed into the HANA studio. So then we have the gateways, different gateways from which we can log in and we can access the data from the from whatever code that we have written. We have basically the SAP UiPath. This FPM stands for Floor Plan Manager. Okay, UI stands for User Interface. So we are going to design user interfaces. As we discussed about the UI5, UI5 history, we'll have Open UI5, which you can get it directly from the Google, and you have SAP UI5, which will be specific to the SAP licensing procedures. So FPM stands for Floor Plan Manager. Okay, Floor Plan Manager, and then we have the WEA and the NWBC, etc. So these are the various tools from which we can access the data which we have in the database, guys. Okay, so we have core data services, which we have discussed. We also created some core data services. Core data services views, okay, CDS views we have created. So CDS stands for core data. So what exactly it means is everything that we write in the core data will be directly hitting the database. Now we have ABAP managed database procedures. Those are called AMDPs. So we will look at the ABAP managed database procedures also. So we have optimized reuse components and lifecycle manager. With this, you get a clarity of what are the things that needs to be covered or we need to learn in the ABAP 7.4 powered by SAP HANA. These are the highlights, guys. So SAP UI5 is very much flexible tool in which you can design the applications which can be the system friendly. I mean, like GUI friendly. What do I mean by GUI friendly is, there was a time when we used to design WebDynamo applications. WebDynamo has almost become obsolete after the introduction of this HANA, ABAP on HANA and UI5 applications, because UI5, when you design an application, it exactly suits the screen. So once upon a time when we used to develop the WebDynamo applications, even if you were able to open it from the mobile, it will open like a website and you have to move this side and that side. You have to do all the four directions. You have to keep moving the screen so that you can see the complete page. You have to move this side, that side, and you understand that, right? So, but now the SAP UI5 is an intelligent user interface in which the interface will exactly suit our system screen, basically the screen. So according to your screen, it will adjust and it will show you all the features in that particular screen. So if you're opening in a phone, you'll have a different design, and if you open it in the tab, it will have a different design, and in the system will have a different design. So something like that. Okay, so these are the things that we have. So we need to focus on the UI5. Okay, so WebDynamo has become, even though it's not that they have stopped doing it, there are some projects in which WebDynamo is still in use, but whereas UI5 happens to be the most happening. So if you are working in an implementation project, chances are that you might be working on UI5 rather than the WebDynamo. So WebDynamo, we need to have a basic idea over it, but UI5 and Fiori is something which is a tool that we are going to use. Guys, this UI5 Fiori application that we are talking about is something which is based on the Java platform, not on the ABAP platform. So you should be knowing the Java coding as well. And in fact, like in the process, UI5 application design is considered as a separate development concept. Okay, so this has been used by UI5 developers. So there will be specifically separate UI5 developers who will be doing it. But as we know nowadays, people are looking for multiple technologies and multiple expertise on multiple concepts for all the people. So it's a race for the survival. Okay, so we need to know a lot of things. So as I told you, in couple of years back, UI5 Fiori is a completely different process in which UI5 Fiori people will be developing it. And workflow was different. WebDynamo was different. AliDux, the cross applications, was a different tool in which people used to work. But right now, everything is combined to ABAP, and we should be knowing all these techniques, guys. Okay, so I repeat what I said. We have development tools in Eclipse, which we have seen performing tools performance tools, and then we have the gateway. So development tools in Eclipse, we didn't see each and every option there, but we just know that we have three types of coding which we can do: the DDL, DCL, and DML coding, right? So then we have done the core data services. ABAP AMDPs is what we have to do, and ABAP language and OpenSQL extensions. This we have done. So we have written select statements which actually have a comma in it. Okay, so then we have you know, the slight changes which we are using actually as a direct you know, SQL statements. Okay, now we have the fundamental concepts. What are the fundamentals you need to know? You need to know the SAP HANA platform. Okay, so for which we have to go through that HANA platform, the core to data paradigm in ABAP. So the database is no longer the bottleneck, adjustments of the classical performance guidelines. And then we have the Eclipse, the integrated development environment. So where we have the ABAP development tools for NetWeaver. So these are the things that we have to know. So core to data paradigm is what we have just seen in the previous sessions. And we also understood the HANA platform. And then we have also experienced the Eclipse, that integrated development environment, where only guys, like, once again, I'm repeating this, Eclipse, only when the Eclipse is installed in the system, you will be able to open that particular ABAP perspective in the HANA studio. Okay. Just like we have seen, for everything, there is a patch that is required. Now we have this SAP HANA platform, more than just another database. So it has like, it has got like this big data, predictive analysis. So we have this big data, predictive analysis, text mining. These are all technologies which have been utilized to manage the main memory of SAP HANA. We have calculation engine. We have analytics and transactions. So this calculation engine takes care of all the calculation views, guys. Okay. So these are all the things that we have in the SAP HANA main memory. Then we have SAP HANA takes advantage of the latest technology developments. So we have 100% in-memory computing. We have OLTP versus and OLAP, which you already know. Column and row storage, you already know. Compression, you already know. Acceleration is like, you know, massive parallelism. Because of the massive parallelism, what do we mean by parallelism? You remember, right? You all remember. I'm sure you all remember that you know, one column will be processed by one core, another column will be processed by another core. Those all will come under the acceleration. Compression is like, you know, repeated data will be, you know, shown only once, those kind of things, guys. Okay, so you all remember that. No aggregates, less indices, and then less code lines, and partitioning is done in the data. So instead of one, okay, so parallelization is different, partitioning is different. Partitioning means what? Dividing the data based on some criteria. Okay, same table, we're cutting short into smaller tables. So because of this, the process becomes faster in the HANA environment. That's very, very important. Now we all know, okay, so we already discussed that computation used to be done mostly in the application server, but now all the code is been shifted to database. It is preferred. It's not that everything will work only on a database. No, application server level also we will be doing some coding in the 7.4 in the SAP HANA, but there will be most of the emphasis will be given on code to data, means CDS. Okay, so if you say code to data or code push down, it means that the code is getting executed at the database level, not at the application server. That's the reason it's called core data services. Okay, this is called core data paradigm, core to data paradigm. Okay, now in this, previously we used to have HANA views used to be accessed by external views. Then database procedures used to be accessed by database procedure proxies, and delivery unit used to be linked to the HANA transport container, guys. But now in the latest one, this is the one which we have recommended. Now previously we didn't have the CDS views concept. Then they introduced the core data services view, when we can write this in the ABAP environment. See, you understand this very carefully. This is a HANA studio perspective, guys. That below one is the HANA studio perspective. What are the things that we can do? SAP HANA views we can do at the HANA studio perspective, right? And core data services, where we can do from the ABAP perspective in the same environment. Then we have AMDPs, where we can do it in the application server ABAP. And database procedures is something which we write at the HANA level. Then we have the standard ABAP transports. I hope this is very clear for you, because we already discussed this. This is just kind of a recap. Then we have this performance guidelines for OpenSQL programming, adjustment of SAP HANA. So I've already shared this document to you all guys. Look, if you want to have a look at before screen or after screen, you can just slide down in the screen in that document. Okay, so we have performance guidelines for OpenSQL programming, the adjustments for SAP HANA. We also had the performance guidelines for the native web app, which we used to use, old web app before 7.4. After 7.4 also we have guidelines. Some guidelines are common, some guidelines are unique for SAP HANA platform guys. So we have keep results sets small. So if you know you don't have to, so keep results set small means what? We should not use select star. Okay, so you know we have seen recently the dump analysis which we were doing yesterday, we were somebody was using select star on the entire table. So entire table in the sense hundreds of fields will be there. In that again, select star means all the fields, hundreds of fields, and then again multiple records. So we are neither restricting it column wise, we are not restricting it row wise. So internal table has got a memory issue. So and memory we can increase that. Who can increase the memories? The administration people, the basis team can increase the memory size. Okay, keep results small, minimize amount of transfer data, minimize the number of data transfers, minimize search overhead, keep load away from the database. These are the things that we have. Okay. Then we have the ABAP development tools for NetSAP NetWeaver. ABAP development tools for SAP NetWeaver. Now here we have superior tool set for ABAP development with higher developer productivity in Eclipse. So we have, these are the Eclipse tools guys. We have lot of features in which we can lot of features of Eclipse which we can experience at the when we are working on the HANA Eclipse platform. So central update site for all Eclipse based SAP design tools. So we have ABAP, UI5, HANA cloud, all these things can be accessed from the Eclipse platform. Eclipse is a front-end tool and it has been designed by an external company, and this has been used here. How can my custom ABAP code benefit from SAP HANA? So this is what we have. Out of box transparent optimizations, optimized protocols, table buffer enhancements, advanced tooling and programming capabilities. So programming analysis tools, reuse components optimized for SAP HANA, database oriented programming models, easy integration of advanced SAP HANA features. So best practices and guidelines have been followed. So performance guidelines, reference scenarios and all these things. So in this, the most important thing that we have to do is we have to detect, optimize and explore. So most of the projects which you might be working on might be a migration project. Migration project means what? Moving from your old SAP version to latest version. So SAP has given a deadline for all the clients to change to the latest version or the S4 HANA version up to 2020. Now that has been extended to 2022 and it might be extended to 24 as well. So what that does mean, what it actually means is they are not going to support that systems. Okay, they're not going, if you have an issue, you have to solve it on your own. SAP will not support you in any way. But then most of the clients are focused on moving from the old version to latest version. So there are a lot of migration projects which will happen in this couple of years. Okay. Next 5 years. Okay, so it's already been started 5 years back, but the momentum was very slow initially, because whenever there is a new version which gets released, clients will always look for the stable version. Even when you are purchasing a mobile phone or laptop, you'll always choose the stable version rather than the latest version. Most of the people do that unless and until you have a big craze about latest versions. For example, there will be some companies, they don't care whether it will be successful or not. They, once the software is launched, they are eager to launch it use it. Okay, so some companies will be like that, but most of the 90% of the companies will be looking at the stable software. They'll be going for stable versions. Okay, so how to detect adjustable ABAP code is what we need to see. Functional and performance considerations. How to optimize ABAP code. How to apply the code to data paradigm to ABAP code is what we'll see. Explore new opportunities. How to integrate the powerful SAP new HANA features in ABAP. And rethink and innovate. These are the things that we have to do. Now we have
Yes.
detect ABAP test cockpit, SQL monitor, and SQL performance tuning. These are the things that we have. So we have what can be detected? Functional considerations. Now we have SAP HANA migration is just a database migration. Everything works as before except native SQL with vendor specific statements, guys. Vendor specific statements means I will just show you this. So native SQL statements, this is a native SQL statement that we are using here. Okay, so we have the vendor specific statements. So this is a native SQL statement wherein we are writing LO underscore result is equals to new. This is a class and this is the method. Select row number from this one. So this is a native SQL statement. Native SQL statement is LO underscore result is the final where the data has to come. But database, since we have select star from this one into for all entries LT, where node key is equals to this much, and this SQL net prefer join. So this is something, the last line which we have is a new addition which will not work in the old version. Select start from my table. Here we have binary search. Okay, check for secondary indexes. So we are just checking for the secondary indexes here. So native SQL with vendor specific statements, database hints, relying on undocumented behavior, implicit database sorting, checking for existence of secondary indices, direct access to physical pools and clusters. So implicit database sorting. So implicit database sorting in the sense, like within the server, are we doing any sorting of the database within that program, and checking for existence of secondary indices. Secondary indices means we'll have primary indexes and we have secondary indexes. Secondary index means we have connectivity between the two tables. So do we have it? And direct access to physical pools and clusters. If there is a direct access to physical pools and clusters, we are going to transform them into transparent tables, which I'm going to discuss later. Okay. Now, a well-written ABAP code runs immediately much faster on SAP HANA. That's for sure. Now, some performance optimization candidates. So we have critical constructs according to the performance guidelines, construct with low database performance profile. So we have select single star. So we are checking the select single star just to make sure that if the data is existing or not. And then we have the nested select statements. We have performance tools and all. Select plus, select for all entries. So we have this select statement and select for all entries. This we can see. We have seen that in the select for all entries, we have seen that kind of a code in the HANA and in ABAP ALVs. We'll be having the select for all entries. So ABAP test cockpit. Now the ABAP test cockpit can be accessed either from the SAP normal login. This is actually the SE80 image, so we can get it from SE80, or we can access it, or we can also access it from the HANA version. So we have SQL monitor, the new runtime monitoring tool in ABAP. So now we have an upgraded version of this SQL monitor. So we have seen the transaction codes which we have to go through in the database, so that like we can just have a hands-on on that. So we had HT02, HT05, all these tools, we have to just explore them. So in the SQL performance tuning work list, we have, you know, we have a development system, and from development system we move everything to the quality system, and from quality system it moves to the production system. But here the static code check identify location of unknown critical code constructs, for example select star. So select star should not be there, right? So those kind of checks we'll be doing in the quality server. We'll be doing that check in the quality server. So the tool that we use is ABAP test cockpit and code inspector. Okay, remember these things and we note down, guys. Like, you know, we'll be later discussing about the transaction codes which we use for that. And then we have runtime information from productive system. Runtime information from productive system will work upon the production server. We have to log in into the production server and do that. And collects performance key figures of constructs. So SQL monitor, SQLM. Combined work list combines the static and runtime checklist results, provides a more comprehensive view. SQL performance tuning worklist SWLT. This is the SQL performance tuning worklist at a glance. So we have ATC check results, detailed check results, and we have SQL monitor data, different request entry points. We have analysis based on combined data from ABAP test cockpit and SQL monitor. So we'll be having this, we'll be testing the SQL performance tuning. So SQL performance tuning, as we have seen there in the transaction, so select star and all these things will be visible here. SQL performance tuning worklist. This is the SWLT transaction. So in the SWLT transaction, when you go there, we'll be able to find out the issues and then we can solve that. So we have optimized SAP list viewer with integrated data access. So integrated data access is something wherein the list viewer, the ALVs that we are using will be integrated with data access. That's what we have to see. Search help with type ahead and fuzzy search, enhanced OpenSQL, and then we have the ABAP Code to Data Services views. These are the things that we have to look into. So start with low hanging fruits. So what happens here is we're just trying to access the data and analyze the data. So we have fault tolerant value helping using SAP HANA fuzzy search. So what is fuzzy search also? We'll just see that. Now we have SAP list viewer with integrated data access IDA. Now what happens in classical ALVs and what happens in optimized ALVs, the ALVs with IDA, okay, integrated data access. So what are the differences is what we'll see here. Now normal ALVs will come from the user interface. Obviously you'll run it from the front end and then it goes to the application server, and after the application server it comes to the database server. Okay, so that's normally what happens. But when it comes to the optimized ALVs, optimized ALVs will directly run on the database. They directly run on the database. Okay, now selection of display data only, data centric operations delegated to the database, declaration of data constraints, authorizations, ranges, complex conditions. Result is retrieved much faster, reduced memory consumption, no truncation of selected data. So in many areas, what exactly SAP did, guys, they tried to avoid the buffering memory. Buffering memory in the sense for example, like internal table work area right? So what are internal table work area? They are runtime objects, which will store the data only during runtime, not before that, after that. Those kind of things are very, very important. Okay, so those things we have to focus upon. Available in SAP GUI and Floor Plan Manager. Search help with type ahead and fuzzy search on SAP HANA. Search for your type. So we'll have faster user interactions using type ahead search in the TimePro based input. Database agnostic word suggestions based on classical F4 help. Fault tolerant full text search based on the SAP HANA fuzzy search. You get some more information about the fuzzy search, guys. Okay, fuzzy search is something which you need to understand more in detail. Okay, and no adjustment in DynPros required. Now, ALV with ID, search help with type ahead and fuzzy search. Okay, type ahead and fuzzy search are very similar to what we have in the F4 help. So here we have address, in from address again we are connecting to business partner, then invoice items and all. Now, enhanced OpenSQL, which we have done. Code pushdown begins with OpenSQL, guys. OpenSQL database abstraction layer defining a common semantic for all SAP supported databases. Delegation of data intensive calculations to the database using OpenSQL. Joins, subqueries, and aggregate functions. These aggregate functions were not there previously. Union function was not there. Enhanced support of code to data paradigm. Now guys, so this is the inner join statement that we are using. So enhanced OpenSQL. So here normally we used to have this table tilt field name, okay, and then we have this comma. Okay, comma is introduced here, and then in this, like SO tilde gross amount plus SO and SO tilde net amount as sum. So we are doing the sum within the select statement only. We are also checking the maximum value within the select statement. Seal, okay. So gross seal gross amount. So seal is like, you know, something like, you know, the maximum limit that we have. In case, we can also put the case condition in the select statement. Then we have right outer join. Instead of inner join, we can also give the right outer join. And group by. So we can, you know, group by is like, you know, we have to collect all the data based on that particular criteria. Okay, so these all things we can do it into table at the rate data LT underscore result. So this is what we have. This is the latest version which we have, the open SQL statements in the latest version. So as we discussed, we have data definition language that we do. So here we can get into the UI5 abstraction. So we have some user interfaces, guys. So core data services will actually work on the database, which we already know. Okay, programming models are here. So it will directly go and hit the. And now the core data services can be consumed from ABAP, HANA Access, or Java. So we have data definition language. Define view and all these things. Advanced view definition with ABAP core data services. ABAP managed procedures, database procedures, ABAP channels. So we have HANA database procedures are there, guys. So we need to declare the procedures. We need to understand how the procedures work. This HANA procedures are at the HANA perspective. Okay. These procedures which we have created the HANA perspective can be consumed by our ABAP managed database procedures. Okay. So these are the database procedures which can be consumed from AMDBs. Now this ABAP managed database procedures provide by means of methods of global classes. So we are going to see what are the global classes that we'll make use of in the AMDBs with tag interfaces. So we can connect to the HANA database procedures through the AMDBs. Okay. So we create HANA procedures in the HANA environment, HANA Studio environment, and then we will consume them from the AMDBs in the ABAP environment. So procedure creates at first AMDB call. Detailed analysis of runtime errors in ST22. We have transport analog to regular ABAP classes. So SQL script, source code, editing in ABAP editor. So we have static syntax check and syntax coloring for SQL script mode. So we have ABAP managed database procedures, AMDBs, class at a glance. So we have AMDB program. It's a program that we are doing here. So here we have CL underscore AMDB underscore sample definition. So we have public section, we have interfaces, if underscore AMDB underscore marker underscore HTTP. This is an SAP standard interface, guys, for this specifically designed for AMDBs. That's the reason we can clearly see this as if underscore AMDB underscore marker underscore HTTP. We have import parameters, export parameters. We can give the methods. We can create the methods here in the class. Now that can be that again we are implementing that class here. So when we are implementing the class in AMDBs, normally what we do, we write method and remaining method, right? But in AMDBs, in ABAP managed database procedures, you have to write this addition here, okay, by database procedure for HDB language SQL script options DB underscore options using and the name one and name two, name three. So this is what we have to remember. So this is by database procedures for HDB language SQL script and options. This is the standard logic that we have to write in the AMDB implementation. So this method which we have, method one is a normal ABAP method. But if it's an AMDP method, then you have to add this additionally when we are doing the implementation, guys. This you can make a note of it somewhere, or you can just, you know, copy it and remember it for longer time, because that syntax is something which we need to remember for a long time. Now we'll have just a demo of the AMDPs, and then we have this real time everything with the ABAP channels. Now we have session one, session two. So now ABAP push channel, so bi-directional communication with user agents via web sockets in ABAP. So ABAP messaging channels, we have a public subscribe infrastructure for exchange of messages between the various user residing on different application servers. So what exactly happens here is you can interact between the system, two systems, two different application servers. You can connect with them, provided they are connected to the same database, integrated with major UI applications like, you know, UI5 Floor Plan Manager, WebDynPro ABAP, Classical DynPro. Those also can be integrated here. But as I told you, you know, the more active one is the UI5 now. Okay, yes. Now here we have this optimized data transfer, code push down. So these are the two things that we have. Optimized data transfer is fast data access for select for all entries and data exchange for stored procedures. And then we have the code push down. So type harmonization, serious views, database procedures and functions. We have service push down, number ranges, gets, NQ services and calendars. So we can have calendars, factory fiscal years and all. Improved operations, aligned HA setup, zero downtime management and overload management. These are the things that we have here. So we have optimized data transfer. So what do we mean by optimized data transfer is we have select for all entries actually used to be a bad code in the previous version, but right now this improvised select for all entries is there. Data exchange for data stored procedures we have. Serious views, it will work on the database. And then we have the number ranges to have a selective data. Improved operations like aligned HA setup, zero downtime management, workload management. Here we have this the end-to-end tutorial available on SCN. So we can just go that. We can access this from SCN and we can just see that. I'll show you that later. Okay, we have the virtual hands-on workshops. You can have the virtual hands-on workshops in this SAP decode hands-on.sap.com. So you already have this you know, document with you, so you can go into that document and click on this and explore that. We have the public webs as well. Okay guys, so we have these are the things that we have here. Okay, so remaining things we'll be discussing in the next coming session.